Hello student, I'm Anjali Sinha, your geography teacher. Today we will discuss the chapter 3 drainage topic, drainage system in India. The drainage system in India are mainly controlled by its relief features. Relief features means physiographic divisions. Accordingly, the Indian rivers are divided into two major groups. Number one, Himalayan rivers. The rivers which originate from Himalayan mountain are known as Himalayan rivers. Example, Ganga, Brahmaputra, Indus. Second, peninsular rivers. The rivers which originate in peninsular plateau are known as peninsular rivers. Example, Mahanadi, Narmada, Godavari. Now boys, differences between Himalayan rivers and peninsular rivers. Himalayan rivers, first point, they originate from snow-capped world's loftiest mountain system, Himalayas. Peninsular river, they originate from Western Ghat or the steep hills of central highlands. Second point, in Himalayan rivers, some of the Himalayan rivers are Ganga, Brahmaputra, Indus. Some of the peninsular rivers are Narmada, Tapi, Godavari. Third point, Himalayan rivers. These rivers are mostly snow-fed, but they also receive water from rain. Third point, peninsular rivers. Peninsular rivers are rain-fed only. Fourth point, Himalayan rivers are perennial, means they have water throughout the year. That means sufficient amount of water throughout the year. Peninsular rivers are non-perennial, seasonal. That means seasonal, they have water during the sufficient amount of water during the rainy season. Fifth point, Himalayan rivers, they perform extensive erosional activities. Hence, they form deep valleys, gorges, etc. Peninsular rivers, fifth point, these rivers have shorter and shallower courses and reliefs like valley gorges are absent. That's all. Look at here. The rivers, major river system of India. First, western side, Indus. Indus and its tributaries. Indus originate from near Mansarovar Lake in Tibet, flow northwestward and fall into the Arabian Sea. Next, you will see Ganga. Ganga originate from Gangotri Glacier from the north, and it flow through northern plain and then it fall into the Bay of Bengal. Third Himalayan rivers are Brahmaputra. It also originate near Lake Mansarovar in Tibet, flow eastward parallel to Himalaya, and near Namcha Barwa it take U-turn and enter in Arunachal Pradesh in India. After crossing Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, it's enter the Bangladesh, and then it join with Ganga and fall into the Arabian Sea. These are the three major Himalayan river system. Now look at the peninsular rivers, Narmada and Tapi. Narmada originate from central highland, flow westward and fall into the Arabian Sea. Now Tapi also originates from eastern side, flow westward and fall into the Arabian Sea. Next, East flowing river, you will see Mahanadi. It also originates from central highlands and flow eastward, fall into the Bay of Bengal. Then Godavari. Godavari is also known as Dakshin Ganga. It is the largest river in peninsular plateau. It originates from Western Ghat, flow eastward and fall into the Bay of Bengal. Next, Krishna. Krishna also originates from Western Ghat, flow eastward and fall into the Bay of Bengal. Next, Kaveri. Kaveri also originates from Western Ghat, flow eastward and fall into the Bay of Bengal. These are the major river system of India. That's all for today. See you next time. Take very good care of yourself. Thank you.